I recently been doing a lot of traveling. I recently went to a little town called Houma, Louisiana. Anybody ever been to Houma? Count your blessings. Houma's about 30 miles south of New Orleans, if that gives you an idea of what year it is there. I'm there all week. My first show is Wednesday night. I walk on stage, I do my show, I get off stage. Guy walks up to me after the show. First words out of his mouth, "Woo! You are funny!" Man, I'm telling you right now, I was watching your show, man, I almost shit my pants. I'm telling you right now! Man, you're going places. I'm telling you that right now. You are going places. And I ain't trying to blow no smoke up your ass. I'll be honest with you, I don't even like black people. No, it gets worse, it gets worse. He goes, "Man, I'll tell you, I was watching you on that stage, you were doing your jokey joke. And I looked over at my brother who was sitting next to me. My brother looks over, he goes, "It's a shame. Lewis must be lonely in that hotel. You know, just sitting around. He don't know nobody, just sitting around all day watching BET. I wish there was something we could do to, you know, show him the beauty of Houma." And then I remembered, hell, we're going hunting on Saturday. So I thought I'd come over and ask you if you'd like to come hunting with us on Saturday. Now, I'll be honest with you, I did consider it. You know, I asked the two most important questions. What are we hunting? And do I get a gun? You know, shit, I just want a fighting chance. So, I tell him no, go away. 2 minutes later, club owner walks over and asks me if I want to go hunting on Saturday. I ask a few more questions this time. I find out there's a big charity event going on. A lot of comedians, actors, producers going on this big outdoorsy charity event to raise money for diabetes. And he wanted to know if I wanted to participate. I said, "Well, you know, it's for a good cause. I'll do it. Plus, I like new experiences, you know? Yeah. I live in New York. I don't shoot anything unless it's touching my car." So I said, "All right, I'll do it." They told me I had the wrong clothes. I had to go out to the Army surplus store. And I went out and I went crazy. I bought the waterproof boots with the camo pants, camo jacket with the camo t-shirt, camo hat with the camo mosquito net and the camo makeup. I was a woodland ninja. I show up Saturday morning. I am camo head to toe. I got the twigs and the hat. Two guys almost peed on me. Now, I don't know if you've ever gone hunting before, but if you have, you know what happens next. The guy comes over with a safety vest, bright orange vest, goes down to here, looks like a Steve Harvey dinner jacket. Well, spring collection. And I look at him, I go, "Bro, do I have to wear this? This kind of ruins the look I was going for. I was going for that commando look, and now I look like a crossing guard." He says, "Sir, you have to wear that because we're hunting deer, and we don't want anyone to mistake you for a deer." Which is one of those things that sounds stupid, but you can't really argue with the logic behind it. You're like, "Bro, okay, all right. Yeah, and what are you gonna say?" Secondly, sir, and this is what gets me. He goes, "Secondly, sir, you have nothing to worry about because deer cannot see orange." Now I'm gonna let that marinate for a bit. I found out later what he should have said was, "Deer are colorblind." See, that makes sense. He didn't say that. He said, "Deer can't see orange," which set off the bullshit alarm in my head, to which I replied, "How the hell did you find that out, really? What are you doing, throwing tangerines at deer? Is that it?" "Hey, Carl, get in here. You ain't gonna believe this. I think we're on to something. I've been throwing bananas at that fucker all morning, and he's been dodging each and every one of them, but them tangerines hit him every single time." So you know how someone tells you something, and you know it's bullshit, and if you don't prove them wrong, right then and there, it's gonna bug you for the next 5 years? I couldn't get that image out of my head of an orange Volkswagen Bug driving down the road, and all a deer can see is four tires and a hippie's head. So I said, all right, if that's true that deer can't see orange, then why are we wearing camouflage? Why aren't we wearing all orange? Big orange jumpsuit. Then we'd be invisible. You know, wouldn't even need a gun at that point. You could use a knife. Yeah, just standing out in the woods waiting. Here he comes. Shh, quiet. Gotcha. Yeah, didn't see me, did you?
Because I'm invisible.
And then I realized how stupid that would be. Me running through the woods of Louisiana in an orange jumpsuit.